Yes, good morning children. How are you? Now again we are here to study our next article of chapter flotation. In our last module we have seen Pascal law and give me the answer from your side. So what is Pascal law? Yes sir, I can give the answer. So give me the answer, that is, in an enclosed fluid, if pressure is changed in any part of the fluid, then the change of pressure is transmitted undiminished to all the other parts of the fluid. Very good, right answer. So now we are going in our next topic, that is buoyancy. B-U-O-Y-A-N-C-Y, buoyancy. What is that? For that, you can take a simple activity. Take a bucket of water or take like this. Here is a bucket of water in which water is there. In this manner. Fill it up. Take an empty sealed can placed in this bucket of water. What we find? Here is an empty can. Here is the empty can. Here is a can. Here is a water. You can take simple activity, take a bucket of water or water can, or here is a simple empty can. Push the can into water like this. Push the can into water. What happened? Can will comes up in upward direction. When you do so, you feel an upward force from here acting on the can. So the upward force here, the upward force on the can goes on increasing as you push the can deeper into water till the whole can is immersed in the water. Is that clear? Aap jaise jaise andar dubayenge वैसे वैसे नीचे से एक फोर्स लगेगा, अपवर्ड फोर्स. तो वंस कंप्लीटली डीप इनसाइड द वाटर, ए फिक्स्ड फोर्स इज नीडेड टू कीप द कैन इन दिस पोजीशन. इट इज क्लियर? नाउ यू मे टेक वन मोर एक्टिविटी, बट बिफोर आई वांट टू से समथिंग मोर, बिकॉज एज सून एज यू रिलीज द कैन व्हेन इट इज कंप्लीटली इन वाटर and you just remove your hand, what happened? You will notice that it bounces back in spite of the fact that the force of gravity pulls it downward. Obviously, I can say water exerts an upward force. Water exerts an upward force on this can, which pushes it upward, and the upward force is greater than the force of gravity. The upward force is greater than the force of gravity. It is clear? So this is greater than force of gravity acting on the can. That is the weight of the can. That is the weight of the can. Is that clear? So this is a very simple activity, dear children. You can do at your home also. One more activity I can do. What is that? You take a cork and place it on a water surface. One more activity I am doing here. Again, take a water can or bucket of water here. See like this.
Here is the water.
Take a cork. Here is a cork. Say like this. This is cork. Dear children, it's promise. Do this activity at home. So here is a cork placed on the surface of water. We find that it floats on water with nearly 2/3 of its volume inside the water. You can see here. 2/3 of this volume is inside the water. If you push the cork into the water, what happens? If you push cork into the water, it returns to the water surface and float again. And float again. In such a case, the cork is to be kept immersed in water with our fingers. We feel an upward force acting on the finger. Once our finger touches the cork, then what we feel? An upward force. What we feel? An upward force here. So from these two activities, I conclude an upward force act on a body. An upward force act on a body here, which is immersed in a liquid. This is called buoyant force. This is called buoyant force. Or buoyant force bhi keh sakte hain. Or it is also called upthrust. Yes sir. Samajh mein aa gaya? Yes sir. Aa gaya. This is called buoyant force or it is called upthrust. And this property due to which a liquid exert an upward force is called buoyancy. Or I can say, write down, property due to which a liquid exerts an upthrust. A liquid exerts an upthrust is called buoyancy. Write down the definition of buoyancy, dear children. I am speaking, you may write. Okay. Yes, sir. Write down. When a body is partially or wholly immersed in a liquid. Immersed in a liquid. We have seen these two activities. Immersed in a liquid, an upward force act on it, which is called upthrust or called buoyant force. And the property of the liquid responsible for this force. Is it clear? Responsible for this force is called buoyancy. Yes sir, maja aa gaya. Is called buoyancy. Okay, now write down. Again read them. When a body partially, यानी कि कुछ कुछ, wholly, यानी कि complete, immersed in a liquid, an upward force acts on it, which is called upthrust or buoyant force. So this property of the liquid responsible for this is called buoyancy. Write down. Now, what is the reason for upthrust? Again, I am explaining. Write down the reason for this upthrust. What is the reason for upthrust or buoyant force? What is the reason for upthrust force? Again, a liquid contained in a vessel. Here is a vessel. In a liquid is there. I am explaining this reason. Why this force acts? The liquid contained in a vessel exert pressure. Suppose here is a block. A, B, C and D. Suppose here is the pressure P1. Here is the pressure P2. Here is the pressure P. Here is the pressure P. Draw this diagram. Then I am explaining. So here in all direction pressure is there. So pressure at a point is same in all direction. Pressure is same in all direction. That is Pascal law. So when a body say A, B, C, D is immersed in a liquid, pressure P1 exerted by the liquid upward on it. Pressure P1 is upward. You can see here. Pressure P2 downward. Okay, so I can say the pressure P1 exerted by the liquid upward on its lower surface CD is greater than the pressure P2 exerted by the liquid downwards on the upper face AB. Okay, so this force, this pressure P1 is greater than to that of P2. So due to this reason that CD rises at a greater depth than the face AB on this block. If F1 and F2 are the forces, on these surfaces, on the surface CD and AB respectively, if A is the area of each side, A is the area of each face of the faces CD and AB. So what is the force F1? Bolo. Force is equal to hota hai, sir, pressure into area, because I know P is equal to F by A. So here is P1 into A. Similarly at this surface AB, F2 is equal to P2 into A. What is this? P1 is greater than P2. So F1 is greater than F2. Seedhi si baat hai. So the net upward force, you can see here. The net upward force, that is the buoyant force acting on the block, that is the buoyant force acting on the block. FB. The buoyant force acting on this block, say FB, that is equal to F1 minus F2. This is, that is equal to P1 minus P2 into A. It is the net force FB acting on the body due to the liquid, that is called up thrust. This is called up thrust of the liquid on the body. So up thrust is due to the pressure difference. Up thrust, it is due to the pressure difference, as we saw here. The P1 is greater than to that of P2. What is the reason here actually? Up thrust force, here I can say up thrust is due to the difference of the pressure on the lower and upper face of the block. Write down the up thrust on a body. Up thrust on a body is due to account of pressure difference, on account of pressure difference, on account of pressure difference between the lower and upper part of the body, between the lower and upper face of the body, upper face of the body. Write down. Here I can say immerse in the liquid. Immerse in the liquid. This is the region. Is that clear? So this is the buoyancy, and what is the region here for up thrust. Okay. Now write this. Now dear children, see another topic. Why object floats on sink? Why object floats on sink or sink, sorry, float or sink when placed on a surface of water? This activity also we are doing here. Again, I want to give you answer this question, when it will float or when it will sink. We are going to perform an activity here with a simple experiment. Again, take a bucket of water. If you take a nail, here is your water. If you take a nail and place it on the surface of water, it sinks like this and nail comes out here. Here is the nail. When you put it here, it will come here. This means that the force of gravity or the weight W of the nail which pulls it downward is greater than the up thrust or the buoyant force FB. For nail, the weight of a nail is greater than to that of buoyant force FB pushing it upwards. The body sinks. First case, a body sinks when weight of a body is greater than the buoyant force In a nutshell, W is greater than FB. A body will sink. Write down first point. This is the first case. Okay. Now, in the second case, if W is equal to less than FB, then the body floats. If you take a cork piece, here is a cork, and place on a surface of water. So you take an activity, take a nail and cork in your left and right hand and put it on the surface of water. The nail and cork both are having the same mass. And place both of them on the surface of water. What do you observe? Cork floats, but sink nails. Cork floats over water while the nail sinks into water. What is this? Now, let us see. The difference in the behavior of the cork and the nail is due to the difference in their densities. What is density? Mass upon volume. The density of cork is less than the density of water. Density of cork is less than to that of density of water. Iski density kam hai kyunki volume jyada hai. Volume jyada hai to density kam hogi. Volume kam hai to density jyada hogi. So density of cork is less. While the density of nail is more than that of water. Density of cork is less than the density of water. While that the density of nail is greater than to that of density of water. As a result of this, for the nail, W is greater than FB. And for the cork, FB is greater than W. This is the reason here. Write down. So what the points we have noted down here? Note that few solids of a different material but having the same mass and place them on the surface of water. What we are observing? We have taken two substances. One is nail, another one is coal. Both we are having the same mass. Place on the surface, what we observe? If the density of the material of a body is less than that of the velocity of water, floats. Here in this case, floats. When the density of material is less than to that of water. And in case the density of the material of a body is more than that of water, it will sink. This is the actual region. आप जिस भी मटेरियल में डाल रहे हैं अगर उसकी डेंसिटी ज्यादा है उस लिक्विड से तो वो सिंक करेगा और कम है तो वो फ्लॉट करेगा. दिस इज द रीजन. सिमिलरली एन एम्प्टी टिन कैन फ्लोट इन स्पाइट ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट डेंसिटी ऑफ टिन and iron is more than that of water. Why? One thing I want to say here, dear children, an empty tin can or a ship largely made of iron floats. It floats. In spite of the fact that the density of tin is more than that of water. Density of tin is more than that of density of water. This is due to the reason that average density. What is average density, sir? Mass upon total volume of the cane or sip is less than that of water. Mass divided by total volume. Mass divided total volume of the cane or sip. Total volume of cane or sip is less than that of density of water. That's why it flows. Instead of water, the above experiment we can repeat in any other liquid. The results are same. You will get the same result, dear children. Okay? So from this experiment, what I conclude here, from this experiment or from this activity, what I get? A body having an average density, write down, a body having an average density and average density greater than the water, greater than the water. Greater than the water, that is liquid, sink. A body having an average density greater than the water, sink. Into it, why? A body of average density smaller than a water liquid, it will float. Sink into it. Sink into it. While A body of average density, not greater, smaller than that of water, smaller than that of water, floats on it. So this is the actual conclusion here. Is it clear? The last case, what happens when both are equal? What happens in the body when the density of the body is equal to the density of the liquid? Tab kya hoga? ज्यादा और कम तो ठीक है. When the density of the body is equal to the density of the liquid, in such a case the body floats completely immersed in the liquid as it is in equilibrium at any position within the liquid. And this is due to the reason I can say FB is equal to W. In such a case the body floats completely immersed in the liquid as it is in equilibrium at any position within the liquid, the buoyant force is equal to the weight of the liquid. A drop of oil stands anywhere within a mixture of equal quantities of water and alcohol, as the density of oil is equal to the density of mixture. Is that clear? So this is the reason here. So dear children, this is all about today. We'll go in our next module and another article, Archimedes' principle and experimental verification. Okay, bye.